What is up, guys? As I'm sure many of you have guessed, what you just saw was made entirely within iMovie. In a video I'm going to do later, I'm going to talk about the visual aspects of it, including green screen tips and compositing for iMovie. If you like the gun blast effect, I went over that in my last iMovie video. But for this one, we're going to talk about sound. So what you're looking at here is my picture lock version of the opening clip, meaning I'm not going to make any more edits. And to get it to this point, I had to export it multiple times, as anyone who uses effects in iMovie know that's kind of a necessary evil. But now that I have it like this, you see there's absolutely no sound at all. And I'm going to add all the sound within iMovie. I have a pretty extensive sound library, so that's what I'm using. But in case you don't, check out freesound.org. It's obviously free, as the name implies, and has plenty of great sounds. All right, now that's all out the way. Let's start with something cool, and that is this gun laser blast. P.S. I know this isn't a laser gun. It's a 9mm, but I don't have any laser props. All right, so here's all my different sound effects. You see, I have a huge library, but you guys could just click and drag one in if you happen to download one that you like, or if you have a library as well, you can just search for it like I just did. So I typed in laser, since this is a laser gun, that made a lot of sense to me, and you see I have a few options to choose from. And in iMovie, you get to see what's called the waveform. So that's what we're looking at here, which is a visual representation of the sound. So I can see the sound kind of spikes quickly and then trails off. The first thing I like to do when I'm inserting an effect is mark in my actual timeline where it needs to happen using a marker, which makes a lot of sense, right? So what I do is scrub the timeline, and you see this is basically where the effect starts here. And then I'm going to use the M key to put in a marker, which is represented by that little blue symbol above my clip. Now that we have the markers in, let's go ahead and put in our sound. So our sound works just like a video clip does, where we can set in and out points. We can do that by either clicking and dragging or using the I and O key. Then I drag my clip down, and because I have snapping turned on, it connects right to that marker. So I have both my laser blasts in. Let's go ahead and listen to them. All right, that sounds pretty terrible. So, and this is where I see many people kind of stop, and that's why you see a lot of bad sound effects. People just kind of put in one effect and let it go. But there's two concepts I want you guys to get out of this, and that is mixing and layering. So let's start out with the kind of mix idea. For this, I'm gonna begin with just using kind of a cheat in iMovie, and that is this audio effect to make our sound sound bigger. As you can see, iMovie has several built-in effects. I'm going to use this robot one. So I think that's really going to add some volume and hit to our lasers. So that's a big difference, but we're not done there. Next comes the layering. This is something that's really going to take your sound to the next level. So for our laser blast, I added two more gun sound effects and then adjusted the volumes to give it a unique sound that I think works great and gives a nice texture. Now we get into the real Foley stuff. The clothes rustling, the holster, the gun clicks. The thing with this, don't think of it too literally. Obviously, guns don't make all those clicking sounds all the time. If they did, they're probably broken. But in film, we're not trying to recreate reality so much as impart a tone of reality or a sensation. And sound helps to do that. So I inserted the gun click and the holster sound. Next, we'll put in clothing. Now, this is a good opportunity to talk about something that's really key in making your sound really work in your piece, and that is to fade in and fade out on the ends, especially if you're only using a specific portion of something that's meant to be longer, like this close sound is. iMovie actually makes that really easy. If you look on the end of every clip, there's an option to fade the audio. So simply click on it and drag in. The next trick I want to show you is reversing sound. So for our holster sound, it's definitely the sound of a gun coming out, not coming back in. So to fix that, we're actually going to flip it backwards. To do that, click on the turtle icon on your adjustment tab, and then just simply check reverse. And now this sounds like a gun entering a holster instead of coming out. Our final trick is going to be retiming a sound. Here's the stock sword sound in my library. You see it happens a little too quickly. So to fix that, we're gonna select the sword sound, then click on the turtle at the top, which makes sense, right? Turtles control speed. Then click slow. When we go down to our clip, you see we have this new little circle slider at the top. What this allows us to do is actually retime it exactly so it's the perfect time that we want. And by not having preserve pitch selected, it changed the sound quality as well, which I think matches our clip better. So this is where we're at now. Something else is still off though, right? It's the lack of what's called room tone, which is simply the ambience that should be happening in the space that your characters are occupying. So no matter what it is, from a bedroom to a hospital to an alien planet, it should sound like something. At no point should the sound ever completely mute. So for this video, I put in some eerie wind. And then the finishing touch, some music. And the track I use is from Video Copilot, their Pro Scores collection. There's plenty of other sources for royalty-free music out there. And what's great about iMovie is that when you drop things on the music track, which is the very bottom one, it's not tied to a clip. So as you start moving things around, the music track stays constant. So there you guys go. From the Foley, to the layering, to the mixing, to adding the room tone, I've created a complete piece here that didn't have any original production sound. If you guys use any of these tips, please let me know. I love to see your work. As always, thanks a lot for watching this. If you have any iMovie questions, feel free to hit me up on Twitter, and I'll see you guys next time.